this video is going to show you how to create custom territories on your map. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to want to open up a map. So I'm going to click here on the shapes map. So here I've got a data set on my map, but the first thing I want to do is click on this add button and then come over to territories and then select draw custom. Okay, so now I have the option to either start drawing my territories or I can edit the style of the territories. So I'm going to do that first. So I have a couple of different ways to customize how my territories will look. I can change the fill and border colors, as well as the fill and border opacities and the border width. So I'm going to give these an orange fill with a red border, and I'm going to make the opacity 60, and then the border width will do 4, and then we'll leave the border opacity at 90. Then we'll click OK. Okay, now in order to draw a territory, it's very simple. All we need to do is we would zoom in on the area that we want, and then you just start to click to create points within the territory. So I'm going to include all these pins in Little Rock area, all the pins in Memphis, and then include also the pins up in Springfield, Missouri. And then I'll close the territory by clicking on the first point. Okay, and once I finish the territory, you can see that it appears over here in my left-hand sidebar in a folder. Now, if I want to continue drawing territories, I would just repeat that same process of clicking and encircling all the pins or covering the area that I want. And then once I've completed the shape, I just want to click on that first point. Okay, once I've done that, I'll click Done. And then custom drawn territories work like any other shape that you've drawn on your map. And what I mean by that is you can click within these individual territories, and Mapline will show you all the locations that fall within that territory that you've just drawn. And it will break them out by data set. So you'll have a column here to identify which data set each location belongs to. If you only want to see a particular data set, you can click here on this button. It'll show you a list of the data sets that have locations within that area. And you can also group your locations based on columns in your spreadsheets. And that's how easy it is to create custom territories using Mapline.